Coaches Show. I hope you enjoyed our intro. We went old school on you with the A-Team theme song. That was a popular show when I was a kid, and I loved it. For those recruits out there, you know, you might have no idea what I'm talking about, but your parents might. They might even actually think that intro was kind of cool. For you film critics and film buffs out there that want to criticize our choppy transitions and our sketch editing, please take it easy on us. We're going for the grassroots type feel of with this coach's show, so it's on purpose. So we just finished our fall team practice part of our fall. It was a good fall. We definitely found out areas what we need to improve on and focus on as we move and head into the second half of the fall, and definitely head into the spring season and preseason. Basically, we got to develop the second half of our pitching staff. We got a lot of young freshmen coming in that are talented. They have the ability to have success at this level, but they got to get more consistent. We got to continue to push our offensive group. We made some adjustments offensively, and we have a lot of returners, position players with a lot of experience that were part of a bad season last year that came in motivated, in shape, ready to rock and roll, and that was apparent early in this fall. The coaching staff made an adjustment on some skill, teaching, and mechanics, technical stuff, and it took like wildfire, and we had a really good second half of the fall, and guys seemed to really understand and grasp the concept and take ownership of the concept pretty well. We just need to master it, and our position players need to take full ownership and mastery of it. Lastly, we need to keep our position players flexible defensively. We have a lot of depth defensively or on the position player side, and a lot of athleticism, which allows a lot of our position players to play multiple positions. And that's important to, one, protect ourselves against injury in the spring, but also be able to consistently put a really quality competitive offense out without having a defensive liability out there. So we will focus on putting a lot of our position players in multiple positions to try to create that flexibility and diversity for myself or in the coaching staff, and putting our best lineup out there. So it was a good fall. We feel like we definitely grew, got better, have a clear idea of what we need to focus and work on heading into the spring, and it was a good fall. Definitely the climax of the fall was ending with our Fall World Series, which was a pretty competitive series. Saturday saw a 1-0 game where the black team won 1-0 behind two great pitching performances, and I won't spoil it. Coach Byerly and Coach Lawhead will be interviewing some of the players and main contributors on both sides and both teams to discuss the Fall World Series. But that was a great climax and end to the fall team practice portion, and it was a good fall. So more to come. I'm going to leave you with Coach Byerly and Coach Lawhead and some interviews, and enjoy the show. More to come.
I'm here with Shane Ozark, MVP of the 2017 Mastodon World Series for Team Black. Shane, after your complete game performance, how does it feel to be unanimously voted MVP of the 2017 Mastodon World Series?
It was incredible. For a second, I retired for about like 12 minutes after, wanted to finish my career on top. But kind of after some self-evaluation, I knew I had to just commit my talents here. I was still in Fort Wayne, be here in the spring, didn't want to ditch you guys.
We appreciate that.
Yeah.
I see why you think that, and I do appreciate that. Since you won the World Series on Sunday and were named unanimous MVP, how has your life changed?
It's crazy. I mean, like, I've been late to class a few times just because people recognize me and kind of want my autograph. But it's cool, though, because when I get to class, professors recognize me, too. They just say, like, you know, it's okay, you don't need to show up, we'll just give you an A. It's cool. I mean, stardom really took me by surprise, but It's been awesome.
Yeah, I saw you being mobbed by third graders out here the other day. It was quite a sight
to
see.
Yeah.
There's a lot of challenges with your team, the Team Black. Talk a little bit about the leadership of Travis Up and Damian Helm and how they piece that thing together to lead you guys to victory.
It started off good at first. But over time, I think they just got each other's heads. They started butt heads a little bit. Eventually, they, you know, kind of wanted an ultimate captain, so they went rock, paper, scissors, best out of 21. But it kind of took too long. But the crazy thing happened. Freshman pitcher Nathan Heffley stepped up, Nate Dogg, and he just looked straight in their eyes and was like, "Hey, look at me. Look at me. I'm the captain now." And guys rallied behind him and had a great outcome. Won the world championship for a Wayne World Series.
So Heffley really pulled that thing
together. Yeah, Nathan was the backbone of our World Series win, yes.
That's great to know. Yep. See, unless you were in that dugout, we didn't realize that was going on. So.
No.
You're dressed up really nice here today. Just curious, where are you coming from? I mean, dressed up like that, what's going on?
I just came from study tables, but Mike Snyder ditched me, had to leave. He didn't show up.
Man, okay, well, thank you very much, Shane, and congratulations on the 2017 Macedon World Series Championship and the unanimous MVP.
Thanks for having me on, guys. Thank you.
I'm here with Brandon Yoho, captain of the blue team and number one hitter in the fall for the Macedons. Brandon, now you were heavily favored on social media to win the series. You had the number one hitter and the number one pick in the draft. How'd you manage to lose?
I mean, I felt like I drafted a pretty good team. Overall, a lot of good hitters. I thought the best pitchers. I thought Cam was kind of very average on Friday, gave up 9 runs. He only gave up 4 hits, but he can't have 9 runs given up. I thought we had more base runners all weekend. I think we had more hits and walks than the other team, just our hitters were not very good with runners in scoring position. That's about it.
Okay, so would you say that your draft strategy or your in-game management is the reason why you lost?
Probably in-game management. My other captain, Brandon Phelps, it was currently a 0-0 game. He had struck out 12 guys, but he gave up a crucial hard hit ball to Mike Snyder that dropped in left field about 20 feet into the outfield. That lost us the series.
So you're saying if you could do it all over again, you'd pull Brandon Phelps in the fifth inning?
Yeah, probably put in Brock Logan or something.
Okay. Brock was the number one pitcher in the
fall. He was the number one pitcher, and we did not pitch him in the World Series.
So pretty bad job by the manager.
Yeah, Brandon Phelps is our pitching coach. I was in charge of the hitters.
Oh, okay. Well, that'll wrap it up, folks.